Angeles, it's time to hear you howl for your Minnesota Timberwolves!
That's the voice of Timberwolves public address announcer Shawn Parker. Every fan throughout the arena can hear his thunderous calls on a Wolves big three-pointer or a Giant throwdown.
The 6'3 guard from Memphis, Derrick Rose!
But unless you know where to look, you may have never laid eyes upon him. Shawn sits courtside with the official score and the team's in-game producers so he can announce the details of what's happening in the game to fans throughout the arena.
6'9, right on time, Taj Gibson!
Now in his second season with the franchise, Parker had a long road to get to where he is today. As we found out, a path in public address announcing isn't always a direct one.
I started out in D.C. doing PA announcing at George Washington University. I had 6 sports there. And while I was there, I decided, let me test out my skills. Let me see where I stack up.
Shawn had to win his job through an audition process after the position finally opened up.
I emailed the Timberwolves. They said they had an audition spot. I flew up here. And 3 rounds later, they offered it to me.
Take me through a typical day in the life of a public address announcer. What time do you arrive here at the arena and kind of what's your process?
Okay, so I get here around 3:30 in the afternoon. We have a 4 o'clock production meeting. After that, go through any pronunciations or whatnot that I need to brush up on. I will take a second look at the script. By this time, I've already gotten it. After that, doors open at 5:30. I do a countdown on that. And then we're off and rolling toward game time. We start our official show about 30 minutes before game time. From there, it's just rolling on toward the start.
How did you come up with your intros and how much time did you put into writing that and trying to tweak it and make it individual for each of the players?
I just gave them everything I had and they were like, that's the kind of energy we want. So then in terms of writing it, I mean, I just kind of sat down, probably took maybe a half an hour to sit down and think about each of the players, look at their names, see what might rhyme with what sounds good.
Can you describe the feeling of sitting down here, hearing your voice boom through a packed arena? I'm thinking back to like game 3 against Houston, that experience. Can you describe that?
It's absolutely amazing. I really get that feedback from the fans and when they're excited, especially, you know, end of game situations, close game, and it really charges me up. So you might hear my voice go up an octave or two. You might hear my volume go up a 2 or 3 notches because I'm excited. I'm a fan just like they are.
Now, I'm in radio. Also, obviously, get a little camera time, but you, no one ever sees you, and yet you are dressed to the nines. Where did this style come from?
Well, first of all, my philosophy about that is look good, feel good, sound good. So specifically with the bow ties, it actually, I had no intention of wearing bow ties. I had never in my life worn a bow tie to my prom, to my wedding, never wore a bow tie. My first game with the Timberwolves, I wore a regular necktie. The second game, I was like, you know what? My uncle gave me this tie. I've got to wear it. You know, I can't waste the gift. So I wore it and everybody loved it. And they were like, that should be your thing. And so I said, okay. And so I started wearing bow ties and I've been wearing them ever since.
Carl Anthony Taylor!